We are. So, good morning.
Good morning.
Hello.
So today we just discussed, it's my topic, or it's not my topic, but it's a topic I like to work on today, and that's grounding. Grounding in any way we can, because more and more we are gathering light and we are losing density, so that more light can get in and more density gets out, and that system is moving faster and larger. And at the same time, we are on planet Earth and we have gravity and we have to do something here and we have to connect with the Earth, the planet. So it's my idea and my wish for today to talk about all kind of ideas we have about grounding. And Patricia also mentioned anchoring. So it's not only grounding, but also to make it fixed in the ground. Mm-hmm. And so that maybe we can talk about exercises, you know. Of course, we put light language and codes in it so that everybody can pick its piece of grounding and anchoring for today's session and benefits from this. And hopefully we are managing to gather even more light. So maybe we can start with a little round of any grounding suggestions or ideas, and maybe also you can put light language or dragons or whatever in, which is helping for these two topics, grounding and anchoring. Patricia, can you start?
Yes, for the part of grounding, I think it's very important to let go of all the stuck energy that's come free in your system. And the best way just to do it without coach or anything is just put your both feet on the ground and focus on the ground.
Rocks off.
Back. Yeah, that's just the easy way. Wherever you are, you can do it. Put your hand on your heart and just not spill, but to breathe it out. Breathe it out and focus that you can just let it go from your top of your feet, of the bottom of your feet, and give it back to earth and give it back to someone else to have that experience, because for you it's done. That's the most easy way to do it wherever you are. Grounding for me is also speak it out. Is also share it with the people around you. So if you're busy in a topic, just share it to your friends, or share it with someone who is in the same interest as you are, or share it on Facebook or whatever fits for you. But don't hold it in your side, because if you keep it inside, it has its own life, and that's just what you don't want if you want to share it. And by speaking it out, you give someone else also the opportunity to ground with you together, so you can ground it all. That's the part of grounding for now. And I just want to say something later on if we put some quotes on it.
Okay.
And for now, I'd like to give the word to Inger.
Yeah. I have used different kinds of grounding techniques throughout the years. What I actually started with was a technique that I learned in the late 80s. And that was actually that as a female, you ground from your sacral chakra. As males ground from their root chakra, females actually anchor in their feminine energy from the sacral chakra and down into the earth to be part of the mother energy, the creative birthing energy that females held in their womb. There is also a chakra behind our knees known as Omega that is equally, or have been equally important to connect to, which is the chakra that holds our connection to the hologram, that actually make our entire experience in this type of reality, which is also very important to have a solid and clear connection too. Then after working with that, I became aware of the Earth Star. And I, as I learned to open my Soul Star chakra above my head, I also understood the importance of grounding into my Earth Star, because when I had those, I felt like a tree. I felt in a strong alignment that my star energy and my earth energy sort of could hold to my higher self, bringing through more and more energy of a higher vibration. Then as I opened more and more, and my body got the understanding that every one of us upon this planet are Gaia. You're an extension of her. And during the release, my body fully came to understand that every time I release, not only do my vibration raise, but the vibration of Gaia raises. And as more and more density have been released from Gaia, and Gaia, I am able to kind of grow into a lighter part of Gaia, I have also needed to ground my multidimensional part. Our multidimensional part doesn't always have a lot of human experience, as it hasn't been in every lifetime that our multidimensional part have managed to kind of get through and stay, because there haven't been any anchor points for it, as the density on the earth have been too dense. But now we can anchor in our and bring in more and more of our multidimensionality. And that made me realize I needed to ground that part into the multidimensional heart of Mother Earth, of Gaia. So I kind of mostly these days ground myself into the multidimensional heart, because when I do that, for my body, it feels like I connect to everything. I connect to every vibration, every level of me on this planet, everything I am, everything I'm to become.
Beautiful.
So that's my...
Yeah, so what I want to do is wrap it up in a big coat.
Yeah.
And then we'll see from there on.
Mm-hmm.
So it's my intention to ground and to support grounding and anchoring of everybody, and to balance these and fine tune it. And we talk about grounding by the feet, with the hand on the heart, the communication, which helps to express and helps the ground as well. We talk about the open heart chakra, to open the heart chakra, to open the throat chakra, the higher heart, throat, and all chakras aligned in this expressing. We talk about opening all chakras and align them so that we can have a system which is leaving energies into the planet Mother Earth. We talk about the sacral chakra for male, for female, and the root chakra for male, so that they will be opened and balanced and fine-tuned as well to help grounding. We talked about the omega chakra, the hologram chakra. We talked about the soul star and the earth star chakras, so that we can balance, fine-tune, and open them further. And also the grounding of the multidimensional part of all beings, and ground that in the multidimensional heart of Mother Earth. Shanaita, u-u-usha. Taina ya ata o totayana uf shu na ana ana ya nyana da shana uku ku shtu ku ku na na tr a re ji ju ju ku to na na ita shur na 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 i ya na na ya ya shu wata ya ta asha ana a nyo foto o shto to oro yara ida ida uku kush onaya vuvota shi tu kuku nya vrta sa vati shukutu koto to koko to ko shoto ko to shoko to koko And all this to fine tune, to balance, rebalance, remember how it all can be working better together. In all time and space, in all lifetimes, for all beings.
Gave me a feeling of complete presence. For me, it was like a huge sun that came closer and closer above my head and kind of shining through smoothly and nicely. And I felt like, you know, tucked in, like into a blanket, present, very, very nice. I also saw that as that energy came through, it was like a mirror point below my feet, that actually it was like above, so below. So there was, felt like a huge and very, very strong and very present alignment.
Beautiful.
In it, yeah. I want to bring in some tree energies, but do you want to say something first, Patricia?
Yeah. Because if something else came up for the for grounding, that with a quote from Roberts, I just felt myself laying down on bed, and I had that experience earlier, so that felt like, hey, I'm gonna share this. If you lay down on your bed and just open yourself up for the energies from above, you can just receive them. And if you take time for it, you can integrate it in your system. And time to integrate information from above is also a part of grounding. Because if you don't allow it to find its way inside you, it's still hanging around, and you feel the parts in your system, in your area, in your head. You feel a bit confused. It's running around in your system, and the information is also grounding. So time is also important. Take time for it to bring it all together.
Beautiful. I got the energies of the big trees coming in. Sometimes, as right now, I'm given the image of a very, very, very big earthly tree, and then it shifts over to become a tree of light, and then it shifts back. So I'm just going to bring in the energies that they are Shamai enemia kiene katai yene ketio kiono tuma. Ayakatisha na mia kateya na miu kutosho na mia tatai. Iaketa maya onokote shia mayana shia maya. Ekia shamay onokoyo koto. Ekia mania katio tosho na aike katena ashana manai. Iakotono yene kitai. And what the trees are showing me is actually the need for us to learn to be completely present. And that grounding have actually a lot to do with not trying to be anything we are not. But to dare to show who we truly are, to be still and to be present. Because we are so trained to fit into and adapt to and align to patterns outside of us that have nothing to do with our true essence. And the true grounding, the true presence comes by daring to be together, showing who you truly are, to be truly present with everything. And I would also say that I love what the two of you are doing. I think you made a video about it once, about you talked about how you kind of took time to sit with each other and be completely honest communication. Mm-hmm. I think that is also a very strong grounding thing actually to do together. Because when you can sit with someone, when you can be completely real, the mirror you get back is your own trueness, which forces you to be completely present with yourself. And I feel that is a beautiful exercise for those who have the possibility to be with someone. Or you can do it with friends if you don't have a partner.
Yeah, and the best thing about it is it's easy to share. It's easy to speak out what you feel I know it's not always easy, but okay, yeah. no judgment here, sorry. But the power is that it's not only to speak it out, but to receive it and give space for the other to speak out too. So mm-hmm. then the balance comes, and then the mirroring is really open. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's just a one-way ticket.
Yeah.
But I still believe for everybody who doesn't have a partner or a friend or friends in this time to talk to,
mm-hmm.
it even helps if you speak it to a tree.
Yeah.
Or your dog or your cat. So put your
hand. Write it down.
Writing it down. Any way to express, to get it out of your system so that it gets into the light.
Yeah.
So that will help tremendously. So and it's a little bit of an old victim program. If you think, yeah, but I don't have a partner, so I can't do that. And that's you victimize yourself.
Yeah.
So maybe I could get rid of those victim programs in all our systems, because these are all aids, and Patricia is right, because it's easy if you start doing it, but there are barriers for starting that, and there's all programs which are creating still the barriers.
And
if you start doing it, if you start talking to trees, if you start talking to your dog or writing it down or whatever feels good for you, or painting it or dancing or whatever, you know, it doesn't really matter. You find your own way, which helps you to do the expression, and the expression makes your cells in your body clean them from old density of this information. But we're stuck in old patterns of I'm not able to do it. I don't have that friend. It's hard for me or whatever. So let me clear a little bit of that. So I will focus my intention on all these programs, which makes us believe that we are not capable of doing the expression route. It's not that we're not able to do it, that we are missing something to be able to do it, that there is any barrier for us not to do something. Let's eliminate these barriers and these programs and the thoughts programs which create them. Shaisha tayanayata, ochichu kuko taina na na icha, vuchita ka shu utadani na yeta taya vutu 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 yoto oya naya o shona o fula. In all time and space, for everybody who's listening to this, shat yotai it anyana voto shotoi I oto yoto. You are a strong being. You can do anything to help yourself be possible to create this expression route, which will help you to anchor and to ground more in this planet. Shushata ita ayata yanayo Shanayaka yuvoto shita ita ito voto yoto voto iti anna ita yashu koto shiri tu vota.
I'm going to put some aspects on it. Let's use the human aspects. And we all think we have negative images on doing it. And be creative or whatever way out for you it is to share. And try to put the negative to the positive thoughts. And then it's in the light. So to give more light to the positive ways to look at things, I'm going to share this with you. Vokoto to pota sa nia katata se titi nia papoto si nia na ako u nia patata ti nia tata nia ta si kriti nia pa o tuko pota nia ata si ti nia papa kata si titi u ga pa nia katata ti tu pota nia na hata ti si ti kapota nia fru kuko tu nia papa tata nia ta kata ti 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 nia papa ti nia tata sa ti ya tata ta si nia ma.
I got this huge wave that kind of washed through me from the field. And what the field informed the body and the bodies with was that it's time to be the true you. Don't stop playing roles. Allow me to wash through you, carrying with me the debris, allow it to fall away. Because there are so many misunderstandings about what awakening is. You think you have to be this way, or you think you have to have these types of experiences or whatever. While true awakening actually is awakening up to yourself, to see yourself, to see your own programming, to take full responsibility for your part of creation. That is true awakening. When you manage to do that, everything falls away and the true you comes forward. And that takes total honesty with self, which is one of the most difficult things for humans to do, as we have been trained to play the opposite role all the time. So it was beautiful what you both brought to in that energy. I got a feel coming in. Let's see what is this. Kaya nia a kia tono ia ka sono mia ka to kaya ka tati na mani ia ka te ia ke tono mashia na ka te ia ka tata yo na mana io ko tono mashia ka ta o io ko te ne meni shana na a kia mana shioto shioto kia ko te o to ti na ma io no kia ke ta na na kia u amma yena shiko toyo Enema nashi ekata namene tika kosh. Eneni akota, eneni akota, eneni akota, shima.
And whatever I'm being shown is that was an energy from what we call an even greater field that we are starting to connect into, and how it welcomes us, how it's opened its portals for us to show us, come on, you're welcome. We await you. We await your participation in this new reality. It cannot happen without you. Feel the safety of stepping into your pure presence and your ability as a co-creator of this. You can do it. Trust yourself. Trust your ability to be present enough to let this energy be birthed through your heart.
I saw them land.
Mm.
I saw them all coming down in little parachutes.
Ah, wow.
And like raining. It was like raining, but raining energies.
Yeah.
And the energies just give some space in the air. In the cloud, so they made little holes where you can just let that part release.
Ah, yeah.
But we had beautiful coats, were really beautiful. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I like them.
Yeah.
How big are they? Like a little raindrop?
Like little balls. I don't know what we saw last week, the orbs.
Yeah.
Not like orbs, but with energies, and then
with parachutes or
yeah.
Oh, cool. Beautiful. Yeah. We saw that last Sunday with the new moon ceremony. Yeah. Right? With then we saw that film of Mallorca where the orbs were.
Yeah, that film you brought. Yeah.
So they had multiple colors.
Yeah,
because we saw one white orb and a yellow orb.
Yeah.
So that you see more color.
Green one.
Mm.
Okay.
No. I saw a yellow and pink, orange. They were the main colors, the three important ones.
Cool. Yeah. Beautiful.
Gold. Yeah.
Yeah, orbs are amazing.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
And I experienced several times when I fine-tune myself when I see them, how I can see faces in it.
Mm.
And I've also seen almost like a being that comes through the orb, that comes out of it.
Mm.
Like an etheric face or face made of light or a being made of light.
Cool.
Yeah. So there are many theories about what orbs is, but whatever it is, it's an possibility for us to get to.
Now we made it clear.
Yeah, closer.
The higher energies, and they're coming here to help us.
So, oh, yeah.
The awakening process, so. Maybe they were already doing that without parachutes, and now they
ended
up with parachutes. So.
Yeah, they're intending to stay.
Yeah.
I think we will experience more and more in the time to come how beings we haven't had full conscious connection with will reappear in our field and our reality, because this is a co-creation.
Mm.
Yeah, and we do it as one from all sides, from all angles. Yeah,
it feels like the orb is very little if we just look with our human eyes.
Mm.
But on the moment we tuned in, they go really big, and they can go in your own orb.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there is your. You can recharge yourself there to find more to recharge to stay by yourself, your real self.
You can
ground and anchor.
Yeah.
This is a nice gift.
Without judgment.
Yeah, beautiful. Wow.
Just pure.
Okay.
Yeah, it's amazing what has taken place the last 3-4 weeks after I experienced a big leap in consciousness in reality shift. It's like the space and our capacity to bring in experiences have like exploded.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Suddenly this and that happened, and then thing happened, and that happened, and suddenly that appears, and
It's for me, it's like it started 1 or 2 months ago when I felt my brain was getting wider.
Yeah.
Then there were no limits anymore of what's possible, and when there's no limit anymore, you can start thinking of orbs with parachute getting down, and it's like, yeah, logical. And because the limitation of our human brain was always keeping that from now, that's not possible, that's something weird. And now it's like, okay, that's interesting. And it's easier together to gather things and understand it. For me, it made it easier to put coach on it. Whenever I can think of, I can put coach in it, and that works. So, and maybe it's also a good idea to open up our systems a little bit more for this beautiful orb energies, which are raining down at us for the anchoring and the grounding, and to set our systems further open. Is that a good idea, or you want to?
I think it's a good idea, and you actually reminded me of something that was brought up a few days ago that I had forgotten until now. You remember several weeks ago, more than a month ago, we worked with activating you brought in some codes to activate our glands.
Yeah.
Yeah. What I got is that with all this very, very high energy that comes in, which is also, as I experience it and many others with me, very aligned to our light body, or our stepping into and connecting to our light body, our meridians needs clearing, because many walk around with blocks in their meridians.
Okay, that's interesting, because I got a course on Starseed U, which is supporting the awakening, but it is in fact clearing and cleaning the meridians. And that's for 4 parts of the chakras, but it's in fact it's the doing the whole Merkaba system of anybody who's listening to that. So let's do that. Let's wrap up the activation of the glands, clearing of the meridians, also the meridian systems we don't know of, and also the gland systems we don't know of, and also open up our brains, our mind system, for all these beautiful energies like these orbs coming down and helping us, so that they're from higher energy systems. There's 8 coming towards us, so that we open up our system, our remembrance, and anything related to that. And it's really stuck into the solar plexus, I feel. So, okay, let's go.
I got this, I almost bursted out in laughter, because when that energy came through, you know these dolls, Russian dolls, where you have one doll and you open it and there's another doll within and you open, there's another one. I suddenly found myself like that, like I was open and there was another one, and I was open and there was another one, and I was unpacking, and there was this tiny, tiny me. But it was such a flow that just cracked through, and made every part of me visible, just lined up. Here you go. This is you. Eat that one, you know.
Eat it, yeah.
Yeah, now you're unpacked. What are you going to do with it?
Finished, John.
Yeah, be aware of Robert. He will unpack you.
Yeah.
Be careful what you wish.
Be careful what you wish.
Yeah.
For me, they were very strong. They were really strong. And I had some visions of being by the dentist. And but then the sound of the codes, and then it's swift off to my system. So I felt like I was just with your laser, I was just right through me, and just one side was falling off. And it felt like a surgery.
Mm.
And a higher up surgery, energetic surgery. So it really, for me, it was really, it really touches my deep. I felt it deep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. For me, I was a bit astonished because the activations in the course are also like these sounds. The dust and like a wolf sound and like insects. Mm-hmm. And because the orbs came from higher energies, and that's where I bring my coach from. So suddenly the relations was there, and I could really feel it in the solar plexus. I was not touching my heart in this time. I was only holding my solar plexus. Later on, I went to the heart, and it was strong, really strong, because it went completely through me. And it makes me always wonder how I'm capable of making these sounds.
I wondered about that too.
Yeah, it's like, and also the it's continuous on a certain height. And when I'm normally, if I would try to sing, it would be like, and now it's like, and the good thing about it is that that's what I get more confident in, is that this is, some people need a whole hour to do this coach, and this is, for me, is the same. It's the same power, even more power. It's just wrapped up in a little piece of information, and so, and it will, like every frequency, it will like a wave move on and on and on and on, so that it's like the stone in the water. You see the ripples, and they never, in fact, they never end. And so this will help in integrate in all these parts, even on the parts that fell out of you, Patricia. It will go on in that. And so I'm really, really curious how this will open us up for these higher energies, and that so that we have the ability to get really to what you saw, Patricia, the orbs with the parachutes, that we will feel that or realize that or see it or anything in that. Yeah.
And what I love with this is that everything that has been invisible is becoming visible.
Yeah.
Which again is this huge confirmation for me that all the work we have done throughout the ages of bringing in and blending realities, bridging them, we have succeeded because it's there. It's visible. It's not the airy, fluffy thing. Mm. It's solid.
Yeah.
And my experience also with the light is that there is nothing more solid than light. Usually you hear that, oh, the body is the physical thing and the light is airy, fluffy, can't be touched or anything. But if you have the experience of bringing in light and kind of touching light, there is a solidity within it, a strength and almost a heaviness within it. Heaviness in the way that when I have a huge donut of light and I get out of bed, I can hardly lift my feet and cross the floor. That's how heavy the light feels in my body.
Yeah.
And as we bring more and more light in, our bodies get solid in a whole new way.
Hmm. Yeah.
So it's such an interesting time because it shifts so much. I'm going to bring in some other energy, but before I have to say things in a moment, they pop in just because I have no memory bank anymore in the usual way. There is something I want us to work with before we leave. And that is a lot of people, when they're bringing more light, want to throw up, feel nauseous, you know? Feel like seasick, feel like they are. Like that.
Mm-hmm.
And especially lately, I talked to many people just last 3 days who have kind of been vomiting, throwing up, feeling really out of it.
And you were not standing on a boat.
Yeah. What? Yeah, like you're walking on a boat, exactly. Yeah,
but you were not standing on a boat when you talked to them.
Yeah. And what I have seen in the energies when it comes to this is that, you know, we have several layers. We have several body. We have the physical, you know, emotional body, mental body, spiritual body. There are layers and layers of bodies that composes us and our aura. When we get downloads, not all of these bodies absorb and integrate at an equal speed. There can be blockage in one body that makes part of your body goes like this and the other part of the field go like different. And that gives you the feeling in your solar plexus of this want to throw up. So that could be something we could see if we can bring in some codes that could sustain us in aligning these bodies better.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know this, there is, I mean, most of us go through it. I learned once that, or what I used to do when I feel really seasick, is kind of connect to my entire field and take my hands and calm down, connect and calm down the bodies and actually ask my higher self and my team to sustain me in balancing it. But then I kind of have to do it every time.
Yeah.
So that could be an interesting thing to see if we could.
Yeah, no problem.
It's but part of the grounding too.
Sorry?
It's part of the grounding.
Yeah, that's part of the grounding. That's definitely part of the grounding. Yeah.
Was there something you wanted to say, Patricia?
I thought
you.
No, let's bring down the codes from Inger. Yeah. I don't know what I want to say something, but it's not coming in my area to speak.
Okay. Do you want
to hang around?
No, I was just feeling into if I should bring in the energies first or Robert. You know what? I think I will bring in some celestial energies first. They tend to be quite high. And then we can take the codes after because then it can. We can see the effect of the balancing of the coming together of them. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see then. Uishen keye honokati oheneke manatoyo uemenia kashai ketenemana Yekete toni akeyo shana heto eti kaya mana kasha yene kote yamana atu akashi usha usha uinei kosh Tanamana katana no menia katana shana na yeto katana menia kaya kota ni ni na 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 yakatana ni 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 Yene metoya ekioko sheni ataka. That was kind of an interesting energy to bring through, because it felt like a huge field that came down. It was filled and empty at the same time. It was like, it felt like a, what I call a field of all possibilities that is presented, it's there, but we are the one who have to activate it by responding to what shows up in our individual consciousnesses from it.
Mm.
And then there was like the earth opened and kind of embraced this energy. There was like a moment where it started to, like the earth, when you bring down energies and the earth answers and bring up to meet, like this coming together of the energies.
Mm.
So it felt like it was brought in a huge field for us to respond upon. And it is what we make it. It holds all possibilities, so it's just for us to pick an apple. Pick an apple.
Yeah, and for this energy, energy you bring, brought down, I felt it shakes to the system. Like that, like an earth shock in your system. And all the layers that it shocked to are the layers that take you away from being yourself. So it's like all the layers with all the stuck energies, the guilt, the shameless, the I don't know what, all the negative thoughts that you can have from the ego that blocks your heart feeling. Mm-hmm. And with the energy, it was shocked, so you can get some space in it. So you can just let it come out. So if you're standing on the boat with the sea going wild, the moment you shake it off, you'll be totally full with your own self.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Then it doesn't matter how hard the waves are going. Yeah, if your ship turns away, okay, then that's just then your karma. But if you
row your boat,
yeah, it feels like you don't even get sick. You just with it.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice.
Goat, Patricia.
Sorry.
No goat.
Yeah. Actually, I have, yeah. Yeah, to help being friendly to your shaking system. Mm. Because it's also allowed to, it felt up for ages. So there's so many, many things that are stuck in your system. It's not a way in one day. So be friendly to yourself and, also to the feeling that comes lost with it. So some friendly and some quietness and some peaceful thoughts to it. Katato, akukutu, akukunu, tukatakanya patanya pana, uyamanaya sitinia pakakanya tananananiyam. Kuhunya mana satia afunamu tokoyotanya pakana nasia punyaya fuya sami matayansa afunamu satu. They say, peace, make love, no war. This what the...
I can agree to that, because immediately when you start to make the sounds, I felt myself taken to a beautiful meadow. Sun was shining, there was flowers in all colors everywhere, and it was like, what do you want to experience now? Because the entire universe is all about experience. Yeah. And everything you get is information.
Mm.
And it's up to you, how do you translate that information? Good or bad? Or neutral? And I just was there and I was looking up on the sun and I think, I just think of a lay down on my back, take a sun bath and look at all the flowers and the bees and the birds and whatever, and just be present with this.
Mm.
It was like, beautiful. Yeah. Then I can be a spiritual hippie.
Yeah, it will be bored if you only have one side. Only the negative, only the positive is balance. Yeah. Experience.
That's beautiful because I think we tipped an hour now, and it's really my wish is that it helps people to be grounded, mm. to be even more grounded, and to anchor that grounding. We touched a lot of topics. If you want more information from any of us, you can find us on Facebook. We are getting more and more into the open with light language, and we can help you in activating your light language, supporting in that route or anything else. Inger can be found on Facebook, Patricia can be found on Facebook, I can be found on Facebook and YouTube. And I hope you liked it. Maybe one of you two want to give a blessing. My mm-hmm. blessing is what I just said.
I can bring it to your blessing, but did you want to do something with the fields first?
No, because I felt that Patricia already done it.
Yeah. Okay. I was just checking so that I didn't overrule anyone.
No.
Okay. Let's do a tree blessing.
Yeah.
To end the grounding, the presence. Amia no kia, amia no ka, eshete miu, eshete ma, eke eme noyo, ekia koshoi, Enemania tiatoi, ekanamaniko, ekia kuta, eshnamania, eshnamena. Shinoyo kemi, iokutoka. Matia, Matia, Matia.
Thank you all.
Yeah, all's been said for today, I think. Thank you all for the beautiful orbs joining us and all the other energies and for all the frequencies we could give. Thankful.
Thank you, beautiful beings. I'm completely blissed out. I couldn't have said a word more.
So I'll stop the recording.
Yeah.
Please, I put flowers in my hair. Yeah.